my dear students. In today's lecture, I will focus on few exercises from ARFCON, in which you will also learn how the calculations are completed. But before I do that, you must turn to page 9 of my notes, and you will see at this page how the electrostatic potential due to a dipole is calculated using the generating function of the Legendre polynomials. So here is the application of Legendre polynomials. So this is the page, and you will see the calculations by which you can find the electrostatic potential due to a dipole. So a dipole consists of two equal and opposite charges placed at Z is equal to the charge plus Q placed at Z is equal to A, and the charge minus Q placed at Z is equal to minus A, and we have to find the electrostatic potential at a point P distant R from the origin. Now I have done the all the steps here. This is the electrostatic potential due to a dipole, with R1 being the distance of the charge plus Q from the point P, and R2 being the distance of the charge minus Q from the point P, and applying cosine law, which is written over here for the two triangles, you will easily see that the electrostatic potential is equal to this term over here, and from there on you can apply the generating function for Legendre polynomials and write the sum equal to this, and you can carry on with further self-obvious calculations here, which are not in fact done in the book, but you can see the detail from my notes, to reach the electrostatic potential due to a dipole equal to 2aq over 4 pi epsilon naught p1 cos theta over r square, and p1 cos theta is in fact cos theta, so you will reach the same result as you may have done in your previous classes to find the electrostatic potential due to a dipole by conventional methods. But here we have applied the application of the generating function, and that has given us the same result very quickly. Okay, now let me switch to the exercises which I want to discuss over here. These are the exercises. 12.1.1 is the first exercise, and here we have to find the electrostatic potential again at a point P distant R from the central, from the origin, due to a quadrupole. Now this is a linear quadrupole. Quadrupole means there are four charges. So here we have two positive Q charges and two negative Q charges. The negative Q charges are placed at the origin. The positive charge are placed, one at Z is equal to plus A and the other at Z is equal to minus A, and you will have to find the electrostatic potential due to this combination of four charges, which is known as the linear quadrupole. Now for this you will have to turn to page let me find out the page for you. I think this is page number 13, so let me display this page before you, which may not be very clear, but if you go through the Photoshop and get my notes, you will find a clear copy. Okay, so page 13. This is page 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. So this is the page at which the electrostatic potential due to a quadrupole is calculated. All these steps are done here, and you see that now our, here is the quadrupole shown, very dim, but get the copy from Photoshop. Okay. So here we have the potential given by 1 over 4 pi epsilon naught minus 2 q over r plus q over r1 plus q over r2, and after simplification we get 1 over r1 plus 1 over r2 minus 2 over r, and now 1 over r1 as obtained from the cosine law applied to this triangle is equal to r square plus a square minus 2ar cos theta power half. Similarly, 1 over r2 is obtained by applying the cosine law on the left triangle, and you get the result this one, and minus 2r, 2 over r. Now from here we have to take r out of the bracket, and you will get this result then, and obviously this expression is quite similar to the generating function, which is 1 minus 2xt plus t square. So you take x is equal to cosine theta and t is equal to a over r, and apply the generating function or the Legendre polynomials. You can easily express to your terms in the bracket like this, and then applying the generating function, writing this result as this, this result as this, and then you will get, you will add these terms in the bracket as I have done here. So go through these steps carefully and try to understand, and then you will carry on and reach to this expression, which is the electrostatic potential due to a quadrupole, and this is equal to 2q over 4 pi epsilon naught into r multiplied by this series from n is equal to 2 to infinity pn cos theta a over r. And if a is much much less than r, then this series can be approximated to just the first term. And when you write the first term, which is with n is equal to 2, you get this result. Okay, and this can be because p2 cos theta is equal to, okay, whatever is the value you can write here. So this is the electrostatic potential due to a quadrupole. Now let's go to the next exercise, which is 12.1.2. And here you have to find the electrostatic potential due to yet another complicated combination of charges. Here we have plus 2q charge placed at z is equal to minus a, and minus q charge placed at z is equal to minus 2a, and minus 2q charge placed at z is equal to a, and plus q charge placed at 2a. So you see there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 charges over here, and this is what is called the linear electric octopole. So this is the octopole, and in the exercise it is asked to find the calculate the electrostatic potential for the array of charges shown in this figure. And so this is a linear octopole, and again I have solved this exercise with all the detailed steps, and let me give you the page number where you can see the solution of this exercise. Okay, let me find the page number. I don't think I have done it here, so it is in fact assigned to the students to do this exercise themselves using the approach we have used in finding the electrostatic potential due to a monopole, due to a dipole, and now it is the octopole. Let me see if I have done it, then I will give you the page number. Otherwise you will have to do this exercise yourself. Okay, it is not here, so you will have to do it yourself and find the electrostatic potential due to a linear octopole. Now let's move to the next exercise. Here we have a dipole again. The electrostatic potential for a dipole at a point P, but now the point P is not too far, it is very very close to the dipole, so that R is much much less than A, and we have to show that the electrostatic potential then comes out to be given by this expression. Okay, I have done it here, so you can go through to the page. Let me see where is this page, and do this solution. Okay, where is this? Okay, this is page number 4. So let me display this, page number 11. Let me display this page over here, and you will have to go through the steps over here. The problem here is that R is very very small compared to A, so you will have to modify the terms and this page number. This page number is 13, and the page we want to go is now page number 11. Where is this page number 11? Is 12 and this is 11. So here I have done this problem, I have done this exercise, and you can see that what we have done here is the same thing, applying the cosine law and getting the potential equal to this. But now the thing is that A is much much larger than R, so we will have to what we have to do. In the previous case we divided the expression by R, but now we will divide it by A, so that R over A remains a fraction. So this is what we have done. We have, instead of dividing by R, we have now divided by A, and the rest you can see very easily and reach this result. Okay, now the next exercise is exercise 12.1.4. In this exercise we have to find the electric field intensity after you have found the electrostatic potential due to a dipole. So electric field intensity will be found by using this expression that E is equal to minus gradient of phi, and we will have to take the gradient of phi. The phi we have already calculated, but the value of gradient must be the coordinates are spherical coordinates, so you will have to use the spherical value of gradient. Okay, I have also done this exercise, and you can see the detail of this exercise. This is again at page 11 in the bottom. So let me display this page. So here is the portion where I have done this exercise, and go through this section and see the solution of this exercise. Okay, so four exercises have been discussed as an application of the generating function for Legendre polynomials. A very much physics problem is being solved using the mathematical knowledge of Legendre polynomials. Now let me see what else. Okay, if I go to this exercise again, right, so I think that's all I wanted to discuss today, but you will have to go through from the ARFCON as well as the first 17 pages of my notes, sorry, 17 pages of my notes to complete your course in the midterm examination. Okay, thank you very much. So go through these pages carefully, and you can have a group study if you are having some problem, and if you still have some problem, you can always consult me at any time, and I will be much pleased to guide you. Okay, thank you very much.